good morning and happy Easter. I may actually be getting this video out on Easter, so happy Easter. If not, then I hope you had a happy Easter. I was going to try to slip in a ride this morning, but it was pouring out. We're going to head out to my sister-in-law's, which is about a two-hour ride up into Massachusetts. And I was going to try to slip that ride in this morning before we left, but the rain had things to say about that. I don't mind riding in rain if I have to, but I don't go out in it on purpose. So, pretty area around here, right? I kind of stole the idea of getting a ride in before we headed to my sister-in-law's, and about 20 minutes before we were due to leave, the phone rings. It is the assisted living where my mother lives, and they had told me they just had to send her out to the hospital. She's been vomiting and her blood pressure went through the roof, which isn't normally a problem for her, vomiting or blood pressure. So I sent the wife and the rest of the family off to the sister-in-law's, and the rain kind of cleared out, so I am taking the bike up to see my mom. That's why I'm riding today. Making lemonade out of lemons. Wherever the hell that goes. I did plan to do a little vlog. Have you ever had a paranormal experience? Or even a cryptid experience? You know, cryptids are those animals that are said to exist but aren't officially recognized. I'll tell you about my experience. It's the paranormal variety. It's a pretty short story, so this video won't go on too much longer. It was a Saturday, and I was heading into work, and I wasn't too happy about it. It was a beautiful day, and I had other things I wanted to do. So, to go into my hospital, to go into my work section of the hospital, I go through the back, and in order to do that, I have to go through this long hallway that passes by the morgue, and to enter the hallway, there's a set of double doors, and to operate it, there's a kind of a, you know, one of those metal buttons on the wall that you pound or touch. So, just past the doors, maybe about 25 feet, there's a foyer to go into the elevator, and there's some lockers in there, and a bathroom, and a back entrance to a doctor's lounge, which is on the right-hand side. So, I'm all aggravated that I have to go in and work, and I'm kind of being noisy. I roll in on the bike, bring it to a hard stop right outside the door because I can park there on a Saturday, and jump off, clean my helmet, shut my music up. So, as I come in, I give that door opener a big hit. Bang! And as I do that, the door's opening, and I see from the hallway, from the, I'm sorry, I see down the hallway in the foyer, a head stick out. And it's an old man, it's clearly an old man, with a derby hat on. No, not a derby hat. The hell are those called? You know those Irish hats, that button in the front. Maybe it is a derby hat. And a very scowly look on his face. But in the moment, I realize that this what I'm looking at is see-through. I mean, I can see the features, and I can clearly see the hat, but the person is see-through. I thought maybe I just, got a little visual impairment or something. It doesn't take me long to get to the hallway, which I realized I was being loud, and I wanted to apologize. But as I approached the foyer, there was nobody in there. It was completely empty. So, I'm getting a little chill just thinking about it now. There's no way a person could have got, if there's a person there in the time it took me to get from the door to the foyer, there's no way that they could have left that hallway and not left some type of evidence that they were going through one of the doors or something. Just not enough time. So, especially a creaky old man. A few more feet down the hallway is a room which was at the time a secretary's room, our secretary for the department. I saw the light on in there and I popped open the door and I saw our secretary, and she was, her name was Juvie. And she was working on a Saturday as well, so I kind of said hello and kind of mused about how bad it is to work on a Saturday, and then she related the story to me that the ER had just transported down a baby that had died just a few hours before from some circumstances, and all of a sudden it just hit me that entity that I saw was in fact Grandpa coming to take the child on to wherever things go to in the afterlife. I knew without a doubt that was the case. So that's my paranormal story. Talk to you later. Oh, it looked like it rained up here. Mom's doing just fine. She's not vomiting. Blood pressure's under control. Of course, the hospital wants to admit her for this, that, and the other thing, but all right, I know the game. They can have her overnight. So everything's looking all right. Hopefully she'll be discharged tomorrow. Thanks for watching. I was going to entertain you on these corners, but this is a pretty fast section of road. It's wet and greasy, so nothing special going to happen today.